Rio Grande Valley is home to more than 10,000 DACA recipients, and yesterday's Supreme Court's decision to keep the program could have paved the way for thousands more. Since 2017, the program has not accepted any new applications, but local immigration attorney says applications are now being accepted. CBS4's Mike Jimenez explains.
Thursday's Supreme Court ruling to continue the DACA program will allow for recipients to renew and file new applications.
I don't think this is an opportunity that people need to miss because, I mean, what if you apply and it gets approved and then later it gets canceled but you still have it for 2 years? So I'm going to recommend my clients to go ahead and apply.
Villalobos says some clients are afraid to submit a new application because of the risk of exposing themselves being here illegally.
They would have your information, and technically, if it gets denied, I mean, they could start sending people, officers out to get these people. I don't think we're at that point, you know, but I mean, with the way this administration is going, I mean, you never know.
Villalobos says it's worth the risk and people should apply before things change. Texas Attorney General Ken Paxton issued a statement after the ruling stating the state currently has a case pending where it is challenging the constitutionality of DACA. Members from La Unión del Pueblo Entero say now that the window is open, Congress needs to take action.
Our congressmen have been working, you know, nonstop for a bipartisan solution, which is truly what we need.
And with the uncertainty of the future of DACA, Villalobos says now is the time.
We'll start the process and we'll get it done, but start collecting all your documents because there are a lot of documents. You have to show that you have actually lived here each single month. So, I mean, get everything together and start applying already.
In McAllen, with Complete Valley coverage, Mike Jimenez, CBS 4 Valley at 5.
Villalobos also says the advanced parole program is also available for recipients to travel outside the U.S., but warns there's no guarantee you can get back into the country.